Learn more about this exciting radio broadcasting opportunity by calling WNZK Radio at 248-557-3500. This is WNZK, Dearborn Heights, Detroit. Your ethnic superstation at 690 days, 680 nights.
Welcome to the Bright Side of Aging. My name is Ike Engelbaum. I'm a pharmacist and the publisher of AmericanSeniorGazette.org. It has been wisely said, you cannot help getting older, but you can help getting old. It has also been said that age is a matter of the mind. If you don't mind, it doesn't matter. My purpose in doing the show is so that seniors and caregivers can share their ideas and questions on how we can age gracefully and in a vertical position for as long as our good genes will allow. And if we've inherited bad genes, how to outwit them. Our topics include senior housing, financial, legal, safety, travel, health issues, interesting senior events in the community, and most of all, tips on how to put old on hold. For over 30 years, Cruz Hearing and Service has helped thousands of people improve their hearing and enjoy the sounds of their life again. If you don't hear as well as you like, Cruz Hearing can help you. They have actually hearing aids that the batteries do not need to be recharged. And they also have a caption phone that you can view for free. And also the phone, if you are over 65, is available to you free. So any phone calls you get, you can see captioned if you don't hear that well. Hey, they've got other stuff. If you'd like a free cookbook, call 1-888-489-8980. That's available. You can call Cruz Hearing Direct at 877-456-2789. The number direct is 877-456-2789.
If your question is, who am I going to call to bring the kind of services into my home that I need because I can't get out? House Calls on Wheels provides both medical and non-medical services in your home. They can bring in doctors, dentists, nurses, therapists, and more. And those medical services are covered by Medicare and most private insurance plans. And they have all sorts of non-medical services, whatever you need. Now, if you use 4 hours or more of non-medical services per month, you're going to get a free personal emergency button telephone that you can use for both emergencies or daily use. Call House Calls on Wheels toll-free for further information. 1-888-489-8980. That's 1-888-489-8980.
And welcome. And have we got a sunny day today or what? I think we have a little of both. We have what then? A sunny day. While we're on the air for the next hour, please feel free to call in at 248-557-3300. 248-557-3300 while we're on the air. First half hour, we do the Bright Side of Aging, and we are proud to have a magazine titled Bright Side of Aging as part of the American Senior Gazette newspapers. And in fact, if you are a senior and want to have your information on email or on the internet, we now are doing a digital version plus a print version. Please call us at 888-489-8980 when we're off the air. We've been doing this show probably for almost half a century. from last century. And I like to reach out to seniors for the first half hour on the air from 11 a.m. to 11:30. We're on WNZK 690 a.m. simulcast on WPON 1460 a.m. So if you have someone that you want to highlight, we always welcome your calls. So feel free to write down 888-489-8980 if you're a senior and want your voice heard. WPON covers the northern part of Oakland County pretty well, and WNZK covers the other part of Michigan. We have had calls all the way up from Sault Ste. Marie, and also, of course, we covered Oakland, Wayne, Macomb. If you're a service provider for seniors, we welcome sponsors, and we certainly can work with you so that we can help you in reaching out more seniors. And since we're also involved with our magazine, we can, as they say in the biz, have multimedia coverage. And if you are interested in coming on the air and you have some message that you feel that is appropriate for seniors for the first half hour, 11 a.m. to 11:30, by all means, call me, as I mentioned, on our toll-free number, 888-489-8980. 11:30, we switch gears for the entrepreneurial spirit. And I'm really excited now with the situation because of the virus. A lot of people have thought themselves, self, do I want to spend the rest of my life doing what I've been doing? I'd like to try something different. One of the positive aspects of the pandemic is that people were forced in a way to rethink. There is a magic word that I have on my OnStar system. Unfortunately, they stopped using it, but I still remember it. That whenever they were giving you directions and you got off course and not followed the directions, the smooth woman's voice would come on and say, recalculate. And they didn't call you a dummy for getting off track. The woman's voice said, recalculate. And I think that's what we should be doing. And I try to bring interesting people, knowledgeable people, that have a message to share with us for seniors, and also not seniors, or seniors-to-be, better put. One of my really exciting moments in life is when I had a chance to meet with an attorney by the name of Jim Schuster. Jim Schuster has been around for quite a while and has sort of wound down a little bit. He's recalculating in his own way, but his knowledge certainly goes on. And I'm so glad to be able to talk to him about the serious issues that really you should consider. One of the interesting and depressing things that have gone on is that with all of the budgets that are being planned and what have you, the seniors many times are overlooked. And there's a new piece of legislation that Jim's going to be discussing with me in regards to the Medicaid Recovery Act. And Jim, who used to at one time be the main man for the Elder Law Association of Michigan, he still is practicing elder law, but not at the same pace as before. And I am pleased because of his knowledge to bring this to your attention and hopefully give you some idea of what can be done. Hello, Mr. Jim Schuster.
Good morning, Ike. So good to hear your voice on radio again. You know, I think that after your introduction, I should be walking on the stage in Las Vegas somewhere. Maybe the Carnegie Hall. I mean, what an introduction. What a man.
Something like that.
Well, something like that. Anyways, Ike, yeah, I know you're a guy that, you know, have a little bit of time. We're tight on time, so let me get right to the point.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to talk about a bill in Congress that nobody knows about, that everybody, every senior, every caregiver, every boomer wants to know about, and nobody's talking about it. So here it goes. Let me give you a picture. You're right, Ike. We call it Medicaid Estate Recovery. And let me paint a picture. Suppose you hear this story. We had to sell the family home and give the money to the government because Dad had Alzheimer's. Mom couldn't take care of him anymore, so she had to put him in a nursing home. They ran out of money and had to apply to Medicaid, pay the nursing home. After Dad died in the nursing home, Medicaid came and told Mom they wanted payback, every penny they paid out, but they would wait until she moved out of the house or died. Well, she died in that home where they lived for so many decades, and the son, daughter, had to get together and sell the home, family home, to give money to the government. That is called Medicaid Estate Recovery. And there's a bill in Congress to end this evil practice. I'm sorry, I'm a lawyer, but I have a personal opinion. I don't think that working families who pay, you know, people who pay taxes 70-plus years should have to pay the government back just because they needed nursing home assistance because they got a disease like Alzheimer's, okay?
Mm.
So, like, that's the picture of it. Now, you're the man who knows the questions, the things that people want to hear. I can go on for a half hour before I even take one breath.
But, well, that's all right.
Let me mention one thing. You know, a lot of your listeners out there would say, wait a minute, you're telling me if I go to a nursing home and, you know, don't have the money to pay a nursing home, and Medicaid's the only program that does, they want me to pay them back?
Hmm.
And they'd say, well, wait a minute. If I go to a hospital and get expensive surgery or cardiac care and have all those weeks of rehab, they don't ask for me to pay them back. What's going on here?
Mm-hmm.
Well, all I can tell you that Medicaid was born in a time when, I don't know if any listeners out there remember Franklin D. Roosevelt.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the idea was of those, what are they called, New Deal programs, was to give a fella a hand up and not a hand out. The idea was to help people get back on their feet. And that was the, if you will, the mother and father of Medicaid back in the 1965. The idea then, if we help people in poverty, well, they could get on their feet and go to work. You know, which during depression and actually any time of day or night, not a bad idea. But what about seniors and nursing homes? Well, that's where the law got a little strange, a little funny. In 1993, they said, well, people have to pay the government back. And let's just say I don't see any reason for it. It doesn't work. And there's just many problems with it. Okay, so let me get to one point, Ike, then I'll let you say, Jim.
No, that's fine.
Listeners.
Go ahead.
Okay, here's what a listener should do. If you don't want to lose your home or the family home because somebody has a long-term care disease. By the way, 46% of the people in nursing homes have Alzheimer's or other dementia. So if auntie, uncle, you name it, son, daughter, mom, dad get Alzheimer's, you want to know about this. And what you want to do is call your representative in Congress. Call your representative in Congress and say, I heard about this bill. Here's the number.
Mm-hmm.
House Bill 6698. It's called Stop Unfair Medicaid Recoveries Act. Isn't that a mouthful?
Mm-hmm.
But just say, I heard about this bill, Stop Unfair Medicaid Recoveries Act, or number 6698.
If you don't mind, repeat it so I can write it down. Go ahead slowly, because
okay.
That's how I write.
Oh, yeah. Okay, the bill number, House Bill 6698.
Uh-huh. 6698.
Has the big long title,
mm-hmm.
Stop unfair Medicaid Recoveries Act. And what people should say is, Representative, I think you should support this bill and end government taking my home just because I have Alzheimer's or something like that. Stop it right now. I'm a taxpayer. I paid tax for 70 years or more, and it's not right.
Well, you know, you know enough about the political arena to be dangerous. And one thing a lot of people make a mistake is that they think if they send in an email or some sort of a note to whoever they feel is a politician that they can do something about. All of these bills usually have someone that's sort of the point person, and the various representatives, depending on whatever arrangements they have going between one another, which I could do another show on, is that the key, if you want anything done, is to contact the legislator that's in your zip code. So many people are not aware of who their representative is. So I have two simple suggestions. If you are involved with a relative or someone that's in a nursing home now that's on Medicaid, you obviously have an incentive to make darn sure that you follow up. But if you are dealing with a relative or someone that's got a long-term chronic condition like Parkinson's or other disease states that they're pending nursing home patients, now is the time to make darn sure that you don't get caught up in that horrendous situation where you have to pay back money that you, at that point in life, I'm sure do not have or spent. So there are two suggestions. Call our toll-free number, 888-489-8980. You can leave the zip code, or if you wish to speak to me directly on any senior's issue, I purposely have this toll-free number, 888-489-8980. And if you press the number 1, they'll connect you with me directly, and I'll be more than happy to talk to you and find out who your legislator is. But if you don't want to bother calling our toll-free number, go to your nearest library or call. You don't even have to go there. And they can give you the information as to who you should contact. You know, the trouble, and many times people have, is that they feel, hey, I'm going to make leave a voicemail or an email, and something magical is going to happen. Nothing magical happens. You have to take the time, because this is vital, folks. Your entire savings can go down the drain, so to speak, or whoever is taking care of you. And I can't think of any other health care service where after you are covered by the insurance that you pay them back. I mean, it just doesn't make any sense. And we're talking literally life and death. And one of the thoughts, Jim, I wondered if you could address, is that for some strange reason, Medicaid is very restrictive as to where they pay for healthcare. So if you're in an assisted or an independent living center, I don't think Medicaid covers that. Is that correct?
Well, you're right, Ike. Now, it's a long story, but, you know, let's just say what Medicaid doesn't pay in assisted living is they do not pay the rent, okay? Now, you can apply to Medicaid for their what they call community services to pay for the medical required help, such as, let's say, an aide to come in and help give somebody a bath, okay, or maybe some toileting assistance. The problem is Medicaid doesn't pay the rent unless you're in a nursing home. And as you and I know, Ike, I mean, you've been around one more block than I have, but I'm not too far behind you. The day was back in the 60s when Medicaid was invented. There's only nursing homes for people to go. If you couldn't take care of grandma in your home, she had to go to a nursing home. Well, nowadays we've got these senior apartments, the assisted living facilities, but Medicaid has not changed with the times. It still thinks that people can only go to a nursing home. That's the only place we'll pay. So that's a technical point for lawyers, but if they change the law, and by the way, Ike, this is part of my rant. Did you know that according to this Genworth study, they're famous for doing all the national reliable studies, the average cost of nursing home across the country, $95,000 a year, but assisted living is $40,000 a year cheaper on the average. Can you imagine that for $94,000 a year compared to $54,000? Do you realize how much money Medicaid could save if they just pay for care in a licensed assisted living facility?
Right.
It'd take a change in the law, but I'll tell you, this Medicaid estate recovery, the study showed, only gets back 0.5% of what they put out. Get that? 0.5%. I guess they have a lot of bureaucrats. But if they paid for assisted living, that's like a 47% savings. I mean, so this law is just so screwed up in so many ways. But pardon me, right on the table, the only thing that's on the table now in the Congress is this House bill to end Medicaid estate recovery. And the next step would be to reform the whole caboodle.
Mm.
That's it. And one other thing I want to mention is I really don't like about this law. Do you realize that if a family realizes they're going to lose the home, let me ask anybody, what's their incentive for paying taxes? What's their incentive for paying insurance? What's their incentive for doing any upkeep or maintenance at all? Yeah, it turns your whole neighborhoods into a disaster zone, right?
Right. Well, the interesting part, it's frustrating when you think about it, is that this is not something revolutionary that you have to think through, is that if you can actually save on expenses right now as we speak, in terms of the excess amount that is wasted only because you're forced into a higher expense area, and in all due respect, there still a lot of great nursing homes. But in most cases, the nursing homes are not exactly the most comfortable type of setting for a lot of people, whereas an assisted living center, you have more of a daily life plus supervision, and the cost of government less than what they are wasting for a nursing home stay. So it's a win-win deal. Again, contact your legislator, and all you need to do is check with your local library as to who is representing you, and you take the time and take a postcard even if it's necessary. The Medicaid estate Recovery Act that they're passing, 6698. 6698.
Yeah, we get rid of the prank.
And get rid of the tax. And if you're interested in some other legal issues, feel free to call our toll-free number, 888-489-8980. And Jim Schuster, although he may not be actively in his office, he has all the connections. So you're a people connector, is that right, Mr. Jim Schuster?
Well, that's absolutely right. And we also, as you know, I'm here in the program giving a little what I call public community service education. We still have our little booklet, Elder Law Mini Course, which covers just about everything, the fundamentals, everything, all the fundamentals people need to know about elder law area covers. So if they call you and say, Ike, we want to get that Jim from booklet, I know you, booklet from Jim, you'll arrange to make it happen one way or another.
Yes, I will be the book arranger versus the loan arranger.
Hey, one more thing. I got our subject of the day, if you got another 60 seconds.
Go ahead.
Some of the legislators, believe it or not, are cold-hearted enough saying, oh, you just want that home for an inheritance. I mean, as if he'd ever lose his home. But you just want an inheritance. Well, I don't know if anybody has been listening to the news in the past, let's say, couple, three, 10 years. Has anybody heard this idea that the American workforce has to be a lot more informed, educated to be compete in the global economy? I mean, I read a Chamber of Commerce report issued 10 years ago saying that the American workforce needs substantial post-secondary education to learn the digital and all the modern skills this country needs the workforce to know for us to be competitive. Now, how does somebody who's working get that education if the employer doesn't provide it? Well, they need time from work, and they need money to pay for it. Well, guess what? This is the same argument that millionaire farmers made when they said we need the money to run the farm to exempt themselves from the estate tax. You know, if you're $10 million, you'll never pay any estate tax. You've got to have over $12 million. So the poor millionaires need money. Working families need money to get the education, right? This is why taking away the inheritance of the house keeps the working families poor. They don't have the money to take time off to go to school, but with the money they get from selling mom or grandma's house, now we can have a competitive American workforce. In other words, Ike, the working families of America need this money, not Medicaid. Thank you.
Right. Well, as always, you bring up a lot of interesting thoughts to follow up on. And again, feel free to call our toll-free number, 888-489-8980. And Jim is winding down, but he's still wound up enough that he can help you as to what your individual situation is. Jim, as always,
it's been
a pleasure. Right now, we're going to take a brief break, and we'll be right back. How much time? Family run for over 88 years, Frentz Hardware has remained family owned and operated. Frentz Hardware is one of a kind. You'll find the newest products offered on TV at very competitive prices. You'll also find safety products, grab bars for bathrooms, battery-operated light switches, remote control devices that you can turn your lamps on or any electrical device. You don't have to run out there anymore. Just press the button. Better yet, just visit Frentz Hardware, located on Main Street at and 11.5 Mile Road. They're open every day. If you wish to call, it's 248-544-8111. That's 248-544-8111. Better yet, just visit 11.5 Mile Road and Main Street, Frentz Hardware. And that sort of wraps it up. And I don't want to leave this segment without my favorite parting thought, which is, yesterday is history. Tomorrow is a mystery. Today is a gift. And that's why we call it the present. Please enjoy your present by looking life in the bright side of living. Welcome to the Entrepreneurs Network Radio Show. Our mission is to interview successful entrepreneurs who are willing to share with us their ideas and experiences, both the successes and the failures. Because as it has been jokingly said, you should learn from the mistakes of others, because you'll never live long enough to make them all yourself. My name is Ike Engelbaum, and I'm the founder of the Entrepreneurs Network of Michigan, which is a group of motivated people that are all interested in helping each other and achieving our personal and professional goals. Please check out our website, EntrepreneursNetworkOfMichigan.com, for meeting schedule as well as self-improvement material. Our philosophy is that if it's to be, it's up to me. For over 30 years, Cruz Hearing and Service has helped thousands of people improve their hearing and enjoy the sounds of their life again. If you don't hear as well as you'd like, Cruz Hearing can help you. They have actually hearing aids that the batteries do not need to be recharged. And they also have a caption phone that you can view for free. And also the phone, if you are over 65, is available to you free. So any phone calls you get, you can see captioned if you don't hear that well. Hey, they've got other stuff. If you'd like a free cookbook, call 1-888-489-8980. That's available. You can call Cruz Hearing direct at 877-456-2789. The number direct is 877-456-2789.
If your question is, who am I going to call to bring the kind of services into my home that I need because I can't get out? House Calls on Wheels provides both medical and non-medical services in your home. They can bring in doctors, dentists, nurses, therapists, and more. And those medical services are covered by Medicare and most private insurance plans. And they have all sorts of non-medical services, whatever you need. Now, if you use 4 hours or more of non-medical services per month, you're going to get a free personal emergency button telephone that you can use for both emergencies or daily use. Call House Calls on Wheels toll-free for further information. 1-888-489-8980. That's 1-888-489-8980.
And welcome, and hopefully you are enjoying this sunny day in Michigan. It's interesting how many times jokes become reality. We always used to joke about that if you want to appreciate the four seasons in Michigan, just pick any one day and you'll have it all in the same day. After incurring snow and stuff, to be able to look out and see what a wonderful state and country we have, it's a delight to see sun. There is something magical about sun, and get out and do your thing, so to speak, and also it's an opportunity for you to appreciate, especially now since things have sort of winded down. It's now, instead of a pandemic, we've gained the status of an endemic. Whatever it is, you certainly want to be cautious, but you don't have to become a hermit either. And the entrepreneurial spirit is that whenever you come up to an obstacle, by all means, make it into an opportunity. And I'm really excited with our Entrepreneurs Network group. Our next meeting is next Tuesday. These are Zoom meetings. So the nice thing is that you don't have to travel anywhere. You can continue in your current situation. You can call from home, from the office, and from the car, and while you're not driving, by the way. Not a good idea to drive and try to speak or listen to a meeting. But the good news is you can save yourself a lot of time and effort and learn a lot of really great strategies on becoming an entrepreneur. Our meetings are from 12 to 1 every other Tuesday, and guess what? Next Tuesday is one of them. And we certainly would welcome your participation. And you can call our toll-free number anytime, 888-489-8980. While we're on the air, if you want to call in, if you have a thought or idea of the topic we're discussing, we certainly welcome your calls while we're on the air. Phone number is 248-557-3300. But off the air, 888-489-8980. And if you're not quite sure as to what career path you should take, please give us a call. We do initial assessments. And we are really blessed in the sense that now, because we've been around as long as we have, since last century, I might add, we have over 20,000 contacts literally throughout the world because people have moved around. And whatever you need, we have someone that's particularly talented in that arena. We have attorneys, we have accountants, we have financial sources, and we also are blessed in having a really guru of the media. His name is Raj Sillars, and cleverly enough, he has a very simple name to his company. It's called Raj Media. Is that right, Raj?
That's right.
That's very creative.
I like to keep things simple.
Well, isn't that the key in life as well as in business? Because so many people mistake that four-letter word they joke about a kiss. They say, keep it simple, stupid. I hate that particular breakdown. It's keep it simple strategy. There's nothing.
There you go.
Right?
I like it.
Right? Well,
yeah.
The truth of it is that in many cases, there are a lot of simple approaches that you can take and be very successful because right now, as you well know, since you head up Rosh Media, you can appreciate the latest in getting your message out. And the good news is that now you don't have to be a multimillionaire to be able to reach literally the whole world. There is digital type of approaches to getting your message out, and like all things, the first step is to find out people that can help you in your journey. And as you know, Raj Sillars, in our entrepreneur network meetings, we have the introductions of the people that call in, and we call it our 60-second elevator pitch. So, Raj, pretend you're at our meeting and you were called upon to give your 60-second elevator pitch. Go for it.
Well, my name is Raj, and I own Raj Media, and our focus is Google. It's quite that simple. And we focus on search engine optimization, getting found online with Google, and that also includes putting ads on Google, as well as YouTube. And those are the three areas we focus on. There are a lot of things you can do in the digital world, but we think Google is still at the top of the list, and we really want to be the specialist, and that's what we do.
Hmm. Now, if someone wants to contact you, how do they do that?
You can go to rosh.media. So instead of .com, it's .media, and you can find us there. And, of course, you can email us and so forth and look at our site and see what we're about. And, of course, I'm always happy to answer questions.
Mm-hmm. So I hate to put you into the world that I have been living in, and that is a telephone. Do you want to give out your phone number twice as well?
Sure. 248-672-4901. And that's actually my cell phone, so you can just blow it up with text if you're listening out there. That's fine. It's 248-672-4901.
Right, and I still like the human being to human being connection, and not to astray from the whole world of digital stuff. Whenever you do send stuff out on the internet and what have you, I think it's important that you do put your phone number on it. I get frustrated many times that, first of all, with all of these scams that are going on, many times you're forced just to give your email, and all of a sudden you don't know exactly who's at the other end of it as to whether they're going to share your contact information. But the human voice is still a powerful way to do things. I admire your style, and you have been in front of our Rotary Club and also Optimus Club, and your services are appropriate not only for individual business people, but for organizations as well. Is that correct?
Absolutely. I work with a number of organizations. I mean, the bottom line is everybody needs to communicate, where they want to sell a product, a service, or an idea, and or even donations, whatever it may be, to support a cause. And there are a lot of ways you can go about that, and not every single option is the right option. So sometimes you need someone to support you to navigate the way through.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, that's something that I think really should be stressed. Don't limit your ways to get the message out. The exciting thing today is that you don't have to just depend on, let's say, in the old days it was direct mail or you made phone calls. Today you can, I'm not discouraging you from doing direct mail. If you have a focused market and you know who you're going to send the mail out to, by all means, go for it. There are a lot of people who want to hang on to it. And
sometimes, actually, Ike, not to interrupt, but just to stay on that track, is that a lot of times we do digital campaigns that go alongside direct mail campaigns. I'm doing that right now with a client who is sending out a direct mail campaign to a certain zip code, and we're also sending digital ads to those zip codes too, and it works really well. They support each other.
Right. Well, that's really the key there, is like when you think about it, with direct mail, you've got the person that you're trying to reach, and I would think that that probably is sort of the ABCs of getting your message out there. First of all, the A part is getting the attention of the a client that can give you a check, write you a check. The thing is that if you're going to just send out in mass a mailing without knowing who is at the other end of it, it's a waste of your money. So the point is, now with the capability of the digital world, you can even identify the demographics. Is that correct, Rush?
Yes, absolutely. We have clients that have very specifics in terms of what they need. For example, they need parents, or maybe they need young parents. So they want parents, say, under 35 or under 30. Sometimes it's people that live in a specific zip code or zip codes, or people that have specific interests. I have clients who, you know, they need people who like to do it themselves and work on their trucks. Very specific. And so we can target ads to those types of people, and or give more weight to those types of ads. And so, yeah, it works out really well. But not everything is paid ads. You mentioned earlier how people can just get their message out there. I have a client who, now we weren't a part of this. You know, he actually literally pulled out his phone and showed something that he was doing in a house, something that was really interesting. And he put it on TikTok. And within 3 days, he had 2.5 million views.
Wow.
And that really helped in many ways. It helped his SEO by driving traffic of people who were interested. So Google recognized that. That helped them. And then people actually messaged them and said, hey, can you do this for us too? And so it's amazing how that can happen. You just have to be a little creative and be ready all the time for interesting opportunities.
Now, when someone contacts you, and that the quickest way I would assume would be roshmediagroup@gmail.com. Is that correct?
You can do that, or rosh@rosh.media.
Rosh.
rosh@rosh.media, M-E-D-I-A.
Mm.
So you replace media with what we often see as .com.
I see. So then when they contact you initially, can you give us a little idea of how exactly does the conversation go?
It generally starts with, what are your goals? What are your expectations? Who are you trying to reach? Are you trying to get your name out there and get in front of a million people? Or do you have a very specific group of people that you're trying to get to? You know, do you want phone calls? Do you want people to connect with you via your website? So figuring out what those goals are, and then we try to figure out what the ROI is, the return on investment. So if we invest $1, do we get $3 back, and or $5, or how much do we have to spend to make sure that it's of value and it's not a six-month project without getting what you were hoping to get? So we're really focused on ROI, and I think that's an important part of it. A lot of times people just jump into marketing and advertising and look at it as a black hole. I think it's a good idea to have a plan on how you're going to, you know, recoup your money and meet your goals and get new customers is part of that plan, and then having measurement along the way. So that's what we do. We just kind of go through that process and make sure this is the right fit, and we point them towards the right tools. Sometimes it's going on YouTube. Sometimes it's improving their position on the web with their website.
Mm-hmm. Now, is there any particular profession that you feel you've been most successful at, or does it go all the way across the board?
It does. We don't focus on a specific profession, because if you think about it, let's say there's a plumber in Troy. Well, I can only have one plumber in Troy, because if I had two, then who do I put at the top of the search engine? So yeah, I can't specialize in one area. And then I often recommend that, you know, when you get a phone call and somebody says, you know, you're a dentist, and they say, wow, we specialize in dentists. Well, that's when I would say hang up the phone, because that means they're not making you the dentist in the area. You're just one of many. And so I think it's important. So, yeah, I sometimes have to turn clients down if there's a conflict over territory or different types of products and services.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So, but to also answer the question, the area that works really, really well, we've done well with law, and we've also done well with the trades. The trades do really well, the plumbers and electricians and people like that. We've had great success.
Hmm. From knowing you and your strategies, you've assisted people many times where they sort of think they know where they want to reach their message, have their message reached, you can assist them in saying, hey, maybe you'd be better off in this area. So you give them direction as well. Is that correct?
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, a lot of my clients also just, you know, I meet with them. Some clients I meet more than others. It just depends on their schedule. But a lot of times they'll come to me with different types of advertising or marketing ideas that we don't do, per se, but are looking for referrals or just wonder, hey, is this a good idea? Should we try this? And I can support them with some ideas and even data that can help them make that decision. So we're sometimes just a good sounding board for other marketing activities. We focus on Google just because we want to be the best at Google. I've written books on social media. I've been very involved in email marketing, and I've been involved in many different things in my career. And that's great, and they're all very, very good. I came out of the print industry, worked in the media. I've worked in the media for a long, long time.
Yes.
But we focus on one thing. But sometimes, you know, clients say, hey, do you think a direct mail piece to this location would be a good idea? And then I can support them in that effort. Or maybe another different type of digital marketing. Would that also support what they're doing? So I like to be a good sounding board and support for my clients.
Sounds good. You should excuse the expression. You're a sounding board. You're a good sounding board. And are your books available for someone to purchase? Or is it...
No, not really anymore. I was early on. I wrote the first book for photographers on digital marketing and social media, but that was over a decade ago now. So my last book was 2013, and that was more photographic related. And I haven't written a new book. I've written four, but it's been a while, so I think I'm due to start getting back for number five. I've been talking about doing number five for a good 7 years now, Ike, so it'll get here.
It's in the works, though. That's right.
Yeah, exactly.
And that first call to you for an assessment, you do not charge for, is that correct?
Oh, no.
Right.
No charge. Always happy. Sometimes people just want to have maybe a 15-minute Zoom meeting or a phone call, or even sometimes face-to-face. All are acceptable and just fine.
Right. Well, that's wonderful. And the ideal way, before we take our break, for anyone interested in Raj Sillars and Raj Media, how do they do that?
If they, how they connect with me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Well, again, my number, 248-672-4901, or just go to Rosh.media.
Rosh.media. So we'll get you in touch with the guru of the media world. How's that?
I like it.
Right now, we'll take a brief break, and we'll be right back. Don't go away. Thank you, Rosh. Family run for over 88 years, Frentz Hardware has remained family owned and operated. Frentz Hardware is one of a kind. You'll find the newest products offered on TV at very competitive prices. You'll also find safety products, grab bars for bathrooms, battery operated light switches, remote control devices that you can turn your lamps on or any electrical device. You don't have to run out there anymore. Just press the button. Better yet, just visit Frentz Hardware, located on Main Street at and 11.5 Mile Road. They're open every day. If you wish to call, it's 248-544-8111. That's 248-544-8111. Better yet, just visit 11.5 Mile Road and Main Street, Frentz Hardware. For over 30 years, Cruise Hearing and Service has helped thousands of people improve their hearing and enjoy the sounds of their life again. If you don't hear as well as you like, Cruise Hearing can help you. They have actually hearing aids that the batteries do not need to be recharged. And they also have a caption phone that you can view for free. And also the phone, if you are over 65, is available to you free. So any phone calls you get, you can see captioned if you don't hear that well. Hey, they've got other stuff. If you'd like the free cookbook, call 1-888-489-8980. That's available. You can call Cruise Hearing Direct at 877-456-2789. The number direct is 877-456-2789. Just a friendly reminder, next Tuesday, the 26th, I'd like to have you join us in our Zoom meeting. We're going to have an exciting speaker as well as the opportunity for you to pipe in and introduce yourself, give your 60-second elevator pitch. The wonderful thing about these Zoom meetings is that you can reach the whole world as long as they know that we're on with our meetings, and literally we do have people calling in or viewing us. So if you're interested, log on to EntrepreneursNetworkOfMichigan.com or abbreviated ENOMichigan.com, or what about the standard way of just calling 888-489-8980. And if you're interested in starting a business and need the financing or need a business plan or possibly a complete marketing program, and if you have a website, we will do a free evaluation to tell you how you can improve your website. All you got to do is contact us. I still love the phones, 888-489-8980. And we can do it literally by phone, even though we're in the digital world. You know that old song about make new friends but keep the old. One is silver and the other is gold. I almost sang that on tune. So the point is, one of the biggest mistakes entrepreneurs make is they're so busy trying to build new contacts that they forget that your existing contacts are literally your bread and butter. The point is that there's an old adage which many times people forget, that your current customers can many times be persuaded to buy more from you. You don't have to run out and get new contacts and avoid taking care of your current ones. There's a couple of companies, in fact, I work with Mailbox Power. They've got a automated way for you to ingratiate yourself with your current customers. And our CEO actually is involved in that. That's his day job. Lou Goutman has advertising alternatives, whereby, you know, people poo-poo the ballpoint pen or the imprinted coffee cup. I got news for you. It's those little ways that you can keep your name in front of your customers, your current ones, that's the key, because that's your foundation. Don't ever forget that. And there's more stuff we can discuss on our next visit, but on this visit, I gotta say my favorite goodbye line, which is, if you really want to get anything done in life, you'll find a way. And if you don't, you'll find an excuse. And there is no excuse for not achieving your dreams and goals in America, because it is the greatest country in the whole world. Remember, a goal is just a dream with a deadline. ¶¶
WNZK has available a few good hours of airtime for a few good programs to serve their communities. Radio is better than ever in targeting an audience that listens to what you say.